All I need is a quick conversation ready you leave. If we could firm up some dates, that'd be good. Thanks, Sarah. What was the ECG show?
All normal.
Temperature?
Sitting at 36, not expecting any arrhythmias.
Okay, good job. I said good job, I don't hand out
Yeah, I did the first time.
This is Anna. Possible pelvic injuries and unable to be awake.
You are?
Brendan, her boyfriend.
Okay, tell me what happened.
It was just a quick race down the road. I didn't think it was that steep.
Cars, bikes?
Supermarket trolleys.
And you thought that was a good idea at the time, yeah? Now, there's a reason why they call that show Jackass.
Your dad's a bit busy at the moment.
When's he off?
Well, we're reckon something downside, same ever. Look, I'm Jill Blackstone. I'll meet you in the cafe, say in 10.
Can I call you back later? I'm just in the middle of something. Give me a couple of hours. Okay. I really have to go now. You too. Bye. Sorry.
Who's that?
Don't know when you'd know.
Try me.
Oh, what are we waiting for? Let's eat.
Don't have to ask me twice.
Was it someone you met on the cruise?
Why would you say that?
Because we know everyone you know.
None of your business, Libby.
Oh, was it that woman that you played bridge with? What was her name? Sammy or Samantha.
So Izzy was thinking South America or Japan for the exchange.
Japan?
Yeah, had to put something down.
You'll fit right in. Watashi no namae wa Etikawaka des.
I don't get it.
I just said my name is Etikawaka. You see, the vowels are the same as those in Māori.
Rightio.
I know why you're here. Come on down, Miss Valencia. Miss Paris.
Miss Ferndale. Forever.
You didn't get in.
I won't. I just know I won't.
Oh, hun.
And then it's all their fault.
Whose fault?
Dad, Sarah, Huia. They've ruined everything. I mean, I don't give a stuff what they do to each other, but why can't they just keep me out of it?
Am I missing something?
Sarah showed up just before my interview, ready to kill Dad. She had a total meltdown and I had to pat her back till Dad turned up. She told me the whole sleazy story.
Now I'm following.
There was no way Dad was coming to my interview after I heard that. No way.
And the panel didn't like you showing up on your own.
They didn't care either way. The whole thing just put me off. I said stupid stuff in my interview.
You lost it.
Completely.
It's rotten what happened, but it's not exactly Craig's fault.
Yes, I mean, it is. And Sarah and Huia. These are the people I'm supposed to look up to. Role models. I mean, all they do is screw up and wreck things for me.
Okay, adulthood 101. No one's perfect. Everyone lets you down.
Are you saying I'm being immature about this?
I'm saying you're not a kid anymore, and this is how it is.
So I should just get used to people letting me down?
All the time.
Oh, yeah, hang on, she's right here. Huia.
Someone from TV, they want to interview Craig.
About what?
They're doing a news story about helicopter rescues, something about a fisherman who keeps getting washed out to sea. They want his perspective now.
Can I wait till the morning?
I've already talked to the helicopter staff and they want to go to air tonight. I can fob them off for you if you like.
Tell them to be here in half an hour.
Warren, suspected lower leg fracture. He's a zookeeper.
Ah, one of the animals got the better of you, mate.
Yeah, elephant. Ow.
Let's slide onto this bed. On my count, please, everybody. 1, 2, 3.
Ah! Oh, between a mother and a calf. She wasn't too happy about it.
Looks like this is all she did.
Oh, it was my fault. I was asking for trouble. Just wasn't thinking.
Seems to be a bit of that going around. Oh. Is that her?
Yeah.
You okay there?
Oh, you guys are really busy. I don't want to interrupt.
Craig, won't mind.
If you could pass on a message. Tell Craig that he needs to go to admissions in half an hour. A TV crew want to talk to him about the fishermen and the effects of rescue efforts on hospital resources.
Won't be keen.
I know. Tell him it's not a request.
Got it.
Oh, just save me some, please.
You already had two pieces.
Oh, I will guard it with my life. Off you go.
Cheers, Yvonne.
Bet you didn't get food like this on the cruise.
It was 5-star every night. I think I put on a kg or two.
Did Samantha put on weight?
Oh, skinny as a rake, that one.
Really? Coffee, anyone?
A good idea.
So what else do we know about this Samantha? She's skinny, she plays bridge, what else?
What's with the 20 questions?
Well, you haven't been the best judge of character, have you? I mean, there's Hamish the con and, what's her name? Glenda the con.
Glennis. But don't worry, I didn't give away my millions.
Yet.
Excuse me?
Stop lying, Mum. We know about Sammy. We know he is a man and we know you had a fling.
How do you know?
I'm okay with that, Mum.
Me too.
Well, I'm not. I want to know more about him. I want to know where he's from. I want to know if he's financially independent.
I said, how do you know?
They saw your photos.
It was your idea. You stole them.
How dare you go through my things?
You wouldn't tell us what's going on.
Because it's none of your business.
He is just a rebound after Dad. You cannot replace him with the first guy that comes along.
Libby. No, Mum, please, don't go.
We won't say another word about it.
Nice one.
You must have nailed those questions today.
To a very big coffin.
Hey?
I sucked.
Nah, overachievers always think like that. Then the results come out. Whatever.
Why are you here?
I want to say thank you for helping me prep last week.
You didn't listen to a word I said and then you walked out.
I mean, to say thank you and sorry.
I don't need sorries anymore. Look, I don't need anything from anyone anymore. Look, do you know why? Because I'm an adult. And that's what adults do. They just treat each other like crap and then get on with it.
Okay. Does this mean we're good now?
Until you treat me like crap again.
Hang on. From what I remember, you weren't that nice to me either. Not that I was going to bring it up.
Oh, get a spine.
Fine. I'll do that right now.
Yeah, and take your chocolate with you. Eddie, come...
Ring her and tell her you're sorry.
Facts are facts. I didn't see the photos, so I don't have anything to be sorry for.
Forget the photos. It's the interrogation. That's what you need to apologize for. I don't see why I should be in trouble because of your big mouth.
I was concerned. I asked questions that needed to be answered. And you two didn't have the guts, so what else was I supposed to do?
Like Mum said, it's none of our business, Libby.
It is our business.
It's not.
It's
not.
Shut up.
Libby's right. It is our business now.
Thank you.
But it's not about you two killing each other, it's about Mum, so can you just calm down and focus?
You are absolutely right, Maya. With Dad gone, it is our responsibility to look after Mum.
Starting with an apology from all of us.
Well, you two go straight ahead, but I know I did the right thing. And Mum will see that soon, and then she'll thank me for it.
I took the liberty of ordering a wee salve. I have never been so embarrassed in my entire life. The girls know.
Well, I didn't tell them, I swear.
They've been snooping. Saw the photos.
Of?
You know.
You and this chap, we're getting it on.
No! What do you think I am? It's just a couple of photos and it sort of looks like that we were just being silly. It's not funny. No child should ever see their mother carrying on like that with another man.
Oh, so what if they saw the photos? It's good for them. They need to see that their mother is still an attractive, vibrant woman.
The thing is, they're worried. Libby in particular.
About what? You had a holiday fling on a cruise ship. Shuttleboard, pina colada, poolside romance is all part of the package deal. Anyway, it's over now. Well, isn't it?
He keeps calling me. Wants to visit.
Excellent.
That's all too much. I'll have to tell him no.
Oh, you can't fight the love boat, baby. You've got to go with it.
What if the girls are right? What if I have got myself into a mess?
Well, it's a nice mess if you ask me. Hot man in pursuit. I wouldn't mind some of that.